Today we are going to consider some questions on the topics that we had already studied in our previous lessons. These questions are related to the previous topics that we had already studied. Therefore, there is nothing new. If something is new, I will talk about that in this lesson. What is the output of the following C program fragment? Before I will explain the program, I would recommend you to please pause the video for a while and try to understand whatever I have written over here. Then come back again and see what I explain in this particular session. Okay, here you see I have written a printf function, and inside this printf function I have written two arguments. One is percentile d. As we all know, this is a format specifier used to print an integer, and another argument is printf function. Now this is something weird. In this argument we usually write a variable or some integer value, but here instead of that I have written printf function. Now what does this printf function do? Inside this printf function, I have provided the argument as percentile s. Now this is something new to you. Percentile s means that we need to print string of characters onto the screen. Percentile s is used to print string of characters. Here, I have provided a string of characters as hello world. If we want to print this hello world on the screen, then we have to use percentile s. Okay, what this printf function will do is that it prints hello world on the screen. This is okay, but what does this printf function do? What does it print? Printf not only prints the content on the screen, it also returns the number of characters that it successfully prints on the screen. Now this is quite important for us to know. This printf function will not only print hello world on the screen, but it also returns the value which is equivalent to the number of characters it successfully prints on the screen. Here you can see the number of characters in this string is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have to include that blank character as well. Don't forget to include the blank character. Okay? Up till now, there are total 6 characters. After this, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then 12. There are total 12 characters that we need to print on the screen, right? So this printf function will also return 12 to this particular printf function as second argument. So this printf function will print 12, and this printf function prints hello world on the screen. Therefore, the output is hello world 12. That is what is expected. Let's consider the next question. What is the output of the following C program fragment? Kindly pause the video for a while and try to understand what this printf is going to print on the screen. Okay. Here, I have provided the first argument as percentile 10s instead of percentile s. And second argument is hello. Now, what would be the output provided by this printf function? Let's try to understand by executing it on code blocks. Here I changed a code a little bit to actually differentiate between these two statements. Let's execute the code. First, printf prints hello simply on the screen, while the second printf prints hello but after some white spaces. This is because of this 10. This 10 means print the characters up to 10 characters wide. This means, here in our example, we just have 5 characters to print. Now because of the shortage of characters, it will print first white spaces and then the rest of the 5 characters. 5 white spaces printed, and after that 5 characters get printed. That is the reason why percentile 10s is used. If we want to print string up to 10 characters wide, then we use percentile 10s. If we want it 15 characters wide, then we write 15 instead of 10. That is the difference between this one and this one. Let's consider the next question. What is the output of the following C program fragment? Here is this program. Let's try to understand what does it really do. Here I have provided a character variable C and assigned it a value 255. You can assign integer values to a character variable. As I already told you in the lesson, when I taught you about the character variable. Here you can see I have provided an integer value to this character variable, and after that I increment that value to 10 and store it again in this variable. Here after incrementing, this will be 265 and I simply print it onto the screen. Can you guess what would be the output of this printf statement? Is it 265? Is it some character according to ASCII table? Is it 7 or is it 9? As we know, this is 255. Character is capable of holding the information up to 1 byte only, which is equals to 8 bits. 8 bit means the maximum value that it can hold is 255 and cannot be more than that. If we try to exceed the range, like in this case, we are exceeding the range because we are assigning to the C variable 265. If we try to exceed the range, then what would happen is that, as we know this thing, that all the data types like character, integer, float, long, double, they all follow, or you can say they obey the laws of arithmetic modulo 2 raised to the power n, where n is equals to 8 in this case. As of character data type is 8 bits long, therefore the n is equals to 8. Here in this case the value is 265, therefore we will calculate 265 mod 2 raised to the power 8. 2 raised to the power 8 is equals to 256, therefore it is 265 mod 256, which is equals to 9. When we divide 265 by 256, we get the remainder as 9. That is why 9 is printed on the screen. And therefore, the answer is D. Let's consider this question. Which of the following statement or statements are correct corresponding to the definition of integer? As we know how to define or declare an integer. Here are some statements written. We have to determine that which of the following statements or statement is correct corresponding to the definition of integer. Is it only first and fifth? Is it just first? Are all correct? Or just fourth, fifth and sixth are correct? Take your time and try to interpret this one by one. Okay, let's understand them one by one. The first interpretation is correct. This is the actual definition of a signed integer. You can also write int I, but instead of int I, you can also write signed int I. Both are one and the same thing. Here writing signed int I, int is a data type and signed is our modifier for integer. Therefore, this is a correct definition. Apart from that, in this second statement, I have written signed I instead of signed int I. Now this is something weird. I have not written anything like int data type or some character data type or any other data type here in this case. Therefore, it seems like an incorrect definition. But I would like to tell you that this is not an incorrect definition. It is correct because compiler implicitly assumed integer data type. If you have not written any data type over here, then compiler will assume this data type is integer over here. Therefore, signed I is equivalent to signed int I. Similarly, unsigned I is also correct. Because compiler implicitly assumed the integer, therefore it automatically puts int in front of this variable. And unsigned I is also a correct definition. On the other hand, long I is also correct definition. That is equivalent to long int I. And long I is equivalent to long int I. Therefore, we can say option C is the correct answer. Because all of them are actually correct, therefore C is a correct answer. Now let's see what does this program prints. Does it print garbage value? Does it print -3? Or does it print integer value that depends from machine to machine? Or is it none of the above? Okay. In the first statement itself, I have written unsigned I is equals to 1. That is equivalent to unsigned int I. Automatically compiler puts int in front of this variable. Therefore, there is no problem. Unsigned int I is equals to 1 means that this integer variable is going to have a value is equals to 1. In the next statement, I have declared a variable j and assigned it a value -4. Inside this printf function, I have written I plus j. This is an arithmetic expression and the result is getting printed using this printf function. I plus j is equals to 1 minus 4, which is equals to minus 3, and that is getting printed. You might think the answer is minus 3, but it is not. Let's try to understand what is the reason. But before that, we must have to know what would be the internal representation of minus 3 in computer. Internally, minus 3 is represented in 2's complement form. Here, I have written certain steps to know how we can represent minus 3 internally in computer. You first have to take 1's complement of 3. That is, this is the binary representation of 3, as this value is set to 1 and this is also set to 1, which is 2 raised to the power 1 plus 2 raised to the power 0, that is equal to 3. And then we perform 1's complement of 3, which is nothing but changing the zeros to 1's and 1's to zeros. Here in this case, I change all the zeros to 1's and 1's to zeros. And this gives me the answer, which is 1's complement of 3. Then in order to produce the 2's complement of 3, we need to add 1 to the result of this 1's complement, which gives us this answer. Now, this would be the binary representation of negative 3. You can say internally that it's represented in our modern computers. Okay, now if I have written percentile D instead of percentile U, this will print the answer minus 3. Now because I have written percentile U, this will be interpreted as an unsigned integer. And we know this thing that unsigned integer maximum value is 4294967295 in the case when integer is of 4 bytes long. We know this thing. Here you can say not all the bits are equal to 1. This bit is not equal to 1. If this is 1, then this would be 4294967295. Because this is not set and its place value is 2 raised to the power 1, which is equals to 2. Therefore, we need to subtract 2 from the maximum value 4294967295. This gives us the answer as 4294967293. This is on my computer. Basically, in my computer, because the size of integer is of 4 bytes, therefore the maximum value is 4294967295, and subtracting 2 from it will give me the answer 4294967293. Maybe this is possible in your computer, size of integer is of 2 bytes, then maximum value would be different and subtracting 2 from it would give something else. Note down this thing. Because of percentile U, the output printed is integer value that depends from machine to machine. And therefore, the answer is C. But if it is percentile D, the output would be minus 3. And that is the major difference between these things. From this example, we have to know this thing and we have to understand this thing that we need to actually read each and every line very carefully when we are answering the questions like this. In GATE examination, such things are very critical and very frequent. They are checking your ability of understanding each and every line. Therefore, such kinds of questions are frequent in GATE examination. Okay, friends, this is it for now. See you in the next lecture. Bye-bye.